Ladies and gentlemen, it's come to my attention that some people think that I, V. Jim Sterling, am arrogant. Let me ask you, is it arrogant for a man to wear sunglasses indoors and a trench coat, stood in front of a shitty felt flag that he made himself, banging on a metal lectern and talking about video games as if people give a shit about his opinion? No. No. The 3DS recently had its price cuts less than 6 months after launch in an unprecedented and drastic move. This appears to be a grim punchline in the sorry and sordid joke that is the 3DS's short history. Nintendo itself clearly thinks the 3DS is failing and that what's offered isn't enough for consumers, but the fans, naturally, disagree. Gamers around the internet are justifying the 3DS's faltering position by claiming that the DS didn't sell well when it first launched either. Like they're reading lines in a well-rehearsed script, these people trot out the same dreary argument whenever the 3DS's failures are mentioned. The DS didn't sell well at first, and now it's really popular. Fucking idiots. Yeah, and of course, because the Super Nintendo did well, so did the GameCube. Now, I'm not about to argue whether or not the 3DS will be considered historically as a flop or a success. I'm more just sick of the same flawed argument being thrown up by morons who can't contextualise. The 3DS might well succeed, but the DS as a measuring stick is bloody stupid because this is not the same market the DS appeared in, and I think gamers are going to have to really start accepting that, not just when talking about the 3DS, but talking about any company in future. The DS's success cannot be used to predict the 3DS's success because it launched in 2004, which, to put it in relative terms, was a long fucking time ago. It launched with very little competition. Common phones were not yet smart, tablets were not gaming devices, and the PSP was the PSP. Today, the market is very different, and it's fucking myopic and ignorant to bring up the DS when the game has completely changed since then. The 3DS has launched in a time where the iOS platform is growing as a gaming destination at an exponential rate, where tablets are being embraced by game developers, and where Sony is prepping to launch the PlayStation Vita for the same price the 3DS launched at. Nintendo is panicking, and its fans are too blinkered to understand why. This same logic applies to the launch lineup. You can argue that no console has ever had a strong launch lineup, like the trained seal you are, but no dedicated gaming console has launched during a period of such intense competition and an era where being a dedicated anything is fast becoming obsolete. The market of 2011 is not the market of 2004. Things have changed. Nintendo has refused to accept that. It ignores the need for a strong digital distribution platform, it mocks mobile developers, and it thinks it can still launch a games console with a lack of games. Wrong, wrong, fucking wrong. This age is not Nintendo's age anymore, and it needs to accept that or drown in the coming tide. So do you, as gamers. This is an age where I can pick up my iPod, download several fun, high-quality games for free almost every day. But Nintendo wants to sell me fucking Xevious for $6. 7 years ago it might have gotten away with that, but not anymore. The 3DS may well become a success, but the DS's success is not the guarantee of that. Gamers have to start realizing that past glories will not become future triumphs anymore. Recently, Sony stated that it is waiting for the PS Vita to get a strong launch library before it releases. That may be corporate bull, but the mere statement is a fact that Sony at least realizes it can't just throw a console out there and wait for time to do the rest. Slow and steady does not win the race anymore, and this is why Nintendo has cost its shareholders money and Satoru Iwata sits on a 50% pay cut. Things have changed. And that's it for another week. It's time for I, the he who shall not be named of video gaming, to bid you adieu. Have a good week and remember in all your endeavours to thank God for me.